Hello, I'm Lisa, and I'm here at McElroy to see their latest innovation, the Tritan 560. It's a self-contained fusion machine that can drive right up to the pipe and start fusing. But what makes it even more unique is that it loads the pipe from the bottom, picking it up right off of the ground. And thanks to this wireless tablet called a data logger, all of this can be done remotely by just about anyone, even me. I have to admit, when McElroy asked me to come out and try their latest piece of fusion tech, I was a little nervous. But with a little help from my new friend Adam, I was driving the Tritan like a pro in just 15 minutes. Maybe not quite like a pro. McElroy's Data Logger 7 has become a mainstay on job sites around the world. Hook it up to any McElroy hydraulic fusion machine, and it can document the process automatically, ensuring that every joint is in line with industry standards. But when you take that same data logger tablet and pair it to a Tritan, it unlocks a whole new set of capabilities. So how did McElroy figure out how to make this tablet control every movement and fusion function of that machine and still make it easy to use? To find out, we're heading behind the scenes to meet the team that made it all happen on an all-new episode of McElroy Made. All right, let's do it. In 2013, McElroy released their revolutionary Talon 2000, an enormous machine made to fuse 78-inch pipe. That's large enough for me to stand inside of. But with a pipe that big, both efficiency and safety became major concerns. McElroy's answer was to self-load the machine from the bottom, picking up the pipe from the ground.
The Tritan 560 came along that took a lot of the advantages of the Talon 2000, put it into more mainstream pipe diameters, and really expanded on the innovation of the bottom loading carriage.
Operators needed visibility while driving and operating the machine. So when it came time to design the Tritan, it was important that they address that need. How they decided to answer it was by wireless control. And to control all those wireless controls, they chose to use the already familiar data logger tablet.
This is the next step where we are not only doing the fusion process from the tablet, but all machine controls are done from the tablet.
On other McElroy machines, an operator may drive from the back of the machine using levers. Loading pipe into the jaws may involve going back and forth between vehicle controls and carriage controls. But the Tritan changes all of that.
It's all about convenience, getting the operator in the exact spot he needs to be at the time that he needs to be there.
So using the data logger to control the Tritan wirelessly makes perfect sense. It allows you to harness all of the Tritan's capabilities without being tied to a single operator location. But that raises the next big question, how? How do you control a complex machine like the Tritan from a little tablet? Can you explain to me how the Tritan and the tablet are actually talking to one another?
So the way that we got them to communicate with each other is a special protocol called, and it's a variant of.
That was John, the senior software developer who worked on the Tritan user interface. We'll get back to him in a minute.
We wanted to be sure that the connection between the data logger and the machine was very reliable. It's receiving all of the data from the machine, as well as transmitting during the entire process that you're fusing. All of the data that we record to the vault is being broadcast wirelessly. So that connection had to be very robust.
Okay, back to John and after a lot of research, they found a way to ensure a tablet connection between the tablet and the machine.
The Tritan is actually full of computerized components. We've got computers in the carriage and in the vehicle. And so what the data logger does is it mostly sends commands to the vehicle and the carriage for those computers to carry out. Ultimately, when you're programming, everything in computers is actually just a string of numbers. It's just this number followed by this number followed by this number followed by this number. And so if you think about it, a string of numbers is meaningless unless you decide how they're going to be interpreted. And so you decide, okay, well, the first number is, say...
Okay, John, we get it. You're super smart. The Tritan computers receive a command from the tablet, then they translate that into a protocol that the computers on the machine can understand called a CAN signal. And it's the same type of system you might find controlling all the electrical components in your car.
We already had the CAN communication protocol ready to go on the tablet. We already had the machine ready to communicate that way. We needed to find a seamless way to bridge it. So the way that that happens is the data logger itself will send out the already formatted CAN signals. It will end up on a, I guess, kind of a receiver, but really it's like a full computer that's already on the Tritan that will take that message, interpret it, and then send it out to the rest of the system.
Then on the machine, there are the valves are actually controlled through electricity. You have a controller that is on the carriage. What it will do is it will command a certain voltage to come out of the computer that will go to the valve, and that will adjust how much pressure that valve is allowing to go through. It allows something that's electronic to control something that is physical.
The technology to communicate is vital for carrying out the inputs from the data logger to the Tritan. But just as important is the user interface, the way the operator interacts with the machine itself. So how did McElroy design a system that's powerful enough to control a complex system like the Tritan, yet simple enough for anyone to pick up and use with confidence?
You know, we're building a brand new platform. That was both the excitement and the challenge of it.
We started off with a very rudimentary user interface on our tablet, where we had all the commands on the tablet on the screen at the same time. They're very small. They were, you know, didn't make a lot of sense.
We have these really cool options and really cool ways to control the machine, but you can't get to it or you don't know how to use it, then they're useless.
So there's not standard tools for doing this, so we kind of had to invent our own. And so we spent a lot of time just trying to figure out exactly what we needed to do, what the user needed from us.
We would meet with our mechanical team, our electrical team, the software development, our tech services, our operators, anyone who has ever used our machine, and a lot of people who haven't, which was something we had kind of focused on. We wanted someone who wasn't used to the machine to be able to walk up to it and be like, McElroy, got it.
While the Tritan is a completely new experience for users, the McElroy team really worked to keep the customer at the forefront of the design.
So the validation team gets to be the voice of the customer when we're interacting with the design teams. And an intuitive design to the developer may not always be intuitive to everyone else who's operating the machine. So during the validation stage, we get to challenge some of those design assumptions. And in the end, that really makes the product more robust, it makes it easier to use, and we just end up with a better product at the end of the day.
With the Tritan having so many moving parts, from positioning the machine to doing the actual fusion, incorporating those on one screen proved to be a challenge for the design team.
We can't really know ahead of time what all things the user is going to want to do at the same time. They might want to move their carriage and move the boom. So what we did is we created a configurable interface. So the center panel of our interface has a selection, so you can say which groups of controls that you want on the screen at the same time.
This feels a little bit like my kid's video game controller. Would you say that was intentional?
Oh, it was definitely intentional. You know, our goal is to make it so that ordinary people without a whole lot of training can just get up and start using this.
It's different than any other product that we've made before. An intuitive design doesn't just happen instantly. So we gave it plenty of development time in our testing facility to run it through its paces to ensure that it was doing what the user expected it to do.
All of this technology is amazing, but how do you make it both safe and responsive on a busy job site?
How do we make sure that we build this process from the ground up, where nothing that you don't want to happen ever happens? Whether you're tracking, whether you're moving, whether you're fusing, we really, really focused on making sure that if anything unexpected happens, your operator and your machine are safe.
To make sure that the unexpected doesn't happen, there's what Jessica calls a heartbeat. It's a constant message between the data logger tablet, the vehicle, and the carriage. It tells the machine that all the components are still here and still functioning properly.
And if you miss three of them, which sounds like a lot, but that will happen over the course of like 30 milliseconds. which is a lot faster than a human.
True.
If we miss those three, that's the point at which we go, all right, shutting everything down. Something is not as solid as it needs to be to guarantee that you're going to be safe. So we're going to let everything settle down until you can resolve what's going on.
How many hours would you say that your team spent testing the data logger?
Over 4,000 hours.
Thousands of hours.
Uncountable hours testing this thing.
Depends on what you consider the start of this process. Smart control, the being able to move through different levels. That was probably 7 years ago.
These days, we're surrounded by incredible technology, and it's easy to take for granted all of the hard work that makes it possible. But behind every groundbreaking, refined experience is an enormous team of engineers, designers, and more working countless hours towards one goal: to create something so intuitive and reliable that just about anyone can pick it up and use it with confidence. That's exactly what McElroy's amazing team has accomplished with the Tritan.
Watching people be willing to take something that they've never seen before and use it in a way that, you know, makes sense to them is really fun to watch.
I love being able to hand a tablet over to a customer who's never seen the Tritan before, definitely never operated it, and see how quickly they pick up the operations. And they're always so surprised. They're always like, this is so cool, I love this.
I actually carry around pictures of the Tritan, and I show people pictures of the Tritan about as often as I show people pictures of my kids. I'm very proud of the work we've done on that.
Every detail was designed with the user in mind to make tough jobs easier, safer, and more efficient.
No, it was incredible seeing the user like fuse with one of these machines for the first time. How quickly people pick up on it was incredibly gratifying.
Yeah.
The focus on making it feel like the same system, even though it's a completely different machine, it's a different manifold. Watching people after half an hour be like, yeah, no, I know how to do this. You guys are, you can walk away. We're good.